Hi everybody, this is Janice with Love and Medium Style, and I figured before I get ready for bed, I would do this quick tag video. I wasn't tagged personally, but I just thought it was pretty a pretty good tag, so I went ahead and it was a pretty easy one, so I went ahead and did it. So number one. How many nail polishes do you own? Well, I did a quick count, and I included the nail polish stripers and the Art Deco and a lot of the clear polishes that I own. I wasn't sure whether or not those were included in that, but with those, I have a total of 611. I know that's more than the average person has, but this is more than just a hobby. It is a career path that I'm on, as wanting to be a cosmetologist. Nails are part of that, so it's more than just a hobby, so that is why I have all these polishes. It's not just because I'm hoarding polishes and never using them, so again, and also I don't think I've bought that many polishes that were at regular price, so it's not like I'm spending tons and tons of money on it. So, number two, which brand do you have the most of? I think I have the most of the Sinful Colors, and I usually buy those when they're on 99 cents at Walgreens. Right now I have a total of 71 of them, so I think that's the brand that I have the most of. Number three, what colors do you have the most of? I don't know if there's any particular color that I have the most of. I did notice that I have more cool tone colors like blues and purples and greens. I don't know why that is. I just, for some reason, I tend to buy more of those colors. Number four, what colors or textures do you not have? I don't know if there's any textures or colors that I don't have, but I know that I don't really care for, and I know this is going to be a lot different than most people. I don't really care for the matte textures. I do have matte textures, and they're okay, but I prefer the glossy, something with a glossy texture on it. For some reason, I just don't really care for the matte texture. A lot of the neon colors that I have a matte texture, and I just don't care for them too much. But I'll wear them, especially during the summer. Number five, what nail polish do you wear most frequently? I don't really wear one kind of polish frequently. I usually buy a polish, I wear that for a while, and then I'll put it away, and then go back to some other polishes and maybe come back to that some other time, but I don't think there's one that I keep wearing frequently. Number six, which one do you keep looking at and wonder why you haven't gotten rid of it? I don't think I need to get rid of any of my polishes. They all pretty much work well. None of them are super, super sticky, and none of them are, you know, down to its last millimeter or whatever. So, I don't really see the need to throw any of the polishes away. Usually when you throw things away, not all the time, but sometimes when you throw things away, you kind of think to yourself, oh, why did I get rid of that? So I think that's why I don't do it. Number seven, what is your go-to base coat? Right now it's the China Glaze strong adhesive base coat. It looks like this. I just bought this week, and I put them on my nails, and they lasted for a while, but no matter what kind of base coat or top coat I use, they're always chipping. No matter what brand, they chip. I don't care how expensive it is, unless I'm wearing acrylics, with a gel overlay, they will chip. So, I don't know. You know, I work and have my hands in water and chemicals a lot, so maybe that's why. So, yeah. Right now it's the China Glaze Strong Adhesion. Before that, I was using OPI's Start to Finish. And before that, I wasn't using any kind of base coat. Number 8, what is your go-to top coat?
My go-to top coat right now, if I'm at class, I use the Start to Finish by OPI. If I'm at home, it's any kind of top coat that's laying around. It doesn't matter. Like I said, it chips anywhere, no matter what kind of polish it is. It just chips.
Number 9, do you like stamping or freehand?
I don't have a stamping set like Conad. I would love to have one, but I just don't. When I'm at school, I do some freehand, especially when I have a long day at work and don't really feel like standing up and I don't have any clients. I might roll a table over to me and get some nail art out and start doing that, just to have some creative juices going and not having to stand up and do anything else. So I'll do some freehand.
Number 10, bling me baby or no bling for me please?
I don't really do a lot of bling. If I have acrylics on, every once in a blue moon I will put maybe a few rhinestones or something on them with a simple design, but nothing too much. That's just not me. So I would say a little bling sometimes, but most of the time it's just one type of color. This is just layering two different polishes on top of each other. I have I think it's Midnight Kiss, or
it's the one by China Glaze. I don't know what it is. It's Mistletoe Kisses,
and on top of that is Party Hardy. So I don't know if this is considered bling, but to me, not really.
So I would say no bling for me, please, unless it's sometimes. Number 11, do you consider your nails naked if there's no design on them?
No, I think my nails are considered naked if there's absolutely no polish on them at all. If there's only, like, sometimes I'll do it, especially if I had just taken off acrylics or something, I'll have a clear coat on them and they'll be naked. Even with a clear coat, I would consider that. But if they have some kind of color polish on, then no, I would consider them naked.
Number 12 is the last one. How many nail polishes have you bought in the past week?
I have bought a total of 8, I believe. 6 China Glaze and 2 OPIs, which I just did a haul on, so yeah. So that is my tag. I will put at the end of this video who I tagged to do this, but you are certainly welcome to do this tag video and send it to me and I'll watch it. Okay, remember to rate, comment, and subscribe. Bye.